me into your accent. Coming up this week, the collision zone between free speech and criminal activity. After a week of violent clashes and soul searching in Charlottesville, big internet giants step in and quell the voice of one notorious website. And another US website's right to free speech has allowed it to host some controversial content. Rules around that may be about to change, but not everyone is happy. That's all coming up on BBC Trending.
Reject data store. So for example, after GodaddyGodaddy was briefly registered in Google, they quickly followed GodaddyGodaddy's lead and dropped the site. And then Facebook started removing the ability of its users to even share that original blog post that denigrated Heather Heyer, the woman who died protesting. Basically, they set it up so you could only share data store if you were condemning it.
Really big, right, Facebook
to
be doing that.
It is a big deal. It's not completely unprecedented, but it's pretty rare. And that kind of freeze has now extended to other sites accused of spreading hate speech. So, for example, another way possible, Digital Ocean announced it was terminating all of its services, not only to Daily Stalker, but also to the controversial crowdfunding platform, Patreon.
So to sum up what you're saying, internet companies are kind of rallying together, and they've actually decided Daily Stalker crosses a line. But that's quite unusual in the US, which of course values free speech massively in the First Amendment to the US Constitution.
This is the disgust about Charlottesville and Daily Stalker reached such a peak that the big corporates decided to make a statement about the limits on what they say is acceptable. And they can, of course, legally do that despite the First Amendment, because all they can do is simply say that Daily Stalker broke their terms of service. But it is a big cultural change. And
you were free speech, they're defending the cause, huge offence. And of course, it now feels like there's a case for this website to find someone who's actually going to host and let them exist.
Right, this is the next part of the story, and it's fascinating. By Wednesday, the site reappeared at a new address, okay, that was being hosted in Russia.
So some of the biggest internet companies are coming together in what looks like an attempt to police online content.
You have to send out signals.
But where does this lead us?
Right, it is that age-old debate, right, of free speech versus new systems of hate speech. But in a really epic way this week it's come to the fore. I'd say it looks like big tech and liberal activists like Amy Siskind have really shifted their position. They are saying that they will shut down what they see as hate themselves, rather than leaving that to the law or the government.
Prosecutors in Britain are being told to treat online hate crime as seriously as abuse meted out face-to-face. Government guidance covers offensives motivated by hostility towards people of different races, religions, sexuality, gender and disability. The Director of Public Prosecutions said online abuse destroyed lives. BBC News.